the fire? What the heck, Kitty? I'm fried. You're supposed to put the fire behind me, not in front of my face.
I'm so sorry. What button is it again?
The one that says screen on it, and why are you drinking?
Bravo? Skylar said it's Sunday fun day, so why not?
Well, the good news is it is not open yet. Can you please bring in the first aid kit?
This is my second bottle.
Okay, I don't know what to do with that. Can you drop the screen, please? Thank you so much. And then you gotta push that other button, because I can't see it. Ah, we have chaos. This is what we were talking about today. We have chaos, which the debt thing again. We have Europe is in a recession. Well, Germany, but that will spread like wildfire. And she got it right. Right on. Good job. Fire behind, not in front. Make face really burnt. And we have GDI talking about recession. GDI suggests that the United States of America is in a recession right now, and we have some of the largest bankruptcies since for a long time ago. And we are at the fastest pace since 2010. But Bravo, the stock market went up today. How could that be? The market's closed. I will show you what territory we are heading into. But really quick, just side note, debt ceiling, Kevin caved, $4 trillion. Enjoy paying that back in your taxes. And tell me this is not all just like the perfect setup for the perfect dumpster fire. Yes. And we have the highest, now this is slightly older, U.S. corporation bankruptcy is at highest level since 2010. But what I wanted to show you is new reports is where the bankruptcies fastest pace in 13 years. And look at that little green line just beaten everything. You go bankruptcies, we're fine. The stock market's higher. It must be so confusing for people, and that's why people are like, oh, it's just, right? It's just a casino. It's a rigged casino. Well, if it's rigged and you know like where it could possibly be going, why don't you make money from it? Also, if you've been on my channel long enough, because you subscribed, you helped me over the two, you know that the economy, okay? Bankruptcies, everyone's locked down, everything's bad. The president just died of lead poisoning like back in the day in a car, and the market actually ripped higher that week. That the economy and the news does not. Actually, it front runs it. This front runs the news. I don't know, it's bass backwards. Or basically this will tell you what the news is gonna say in a month from now or a week from now. The markets always know. And the news, it's always backwards. So when I've been long, everyone's like, why are you long? Shouldn't you be short? And then when I'm short, everyone's like, shouldn't you be long? Even though I'm short. 5'7", which, yeah, that's short. But I wear really big shoes, so that puts me at 5'8", 5'9", big hair, but also a big sock. But at the end of the day, it's just all marketing. Also, again, so this is bad. But I'm so confused. Why market go higher? Well, that's because you're above the 200-day moving average. And if you take my courses, even my most simplest one, that's my swing trading, which it is Memorial Day weekend. So I picked a course and I said, I will do today, $199, Memorial Day, which is so sad for me. Oh, wait, did I say how much? $199 or $200? $199? You'll go, oh, wow, this is, I've never seen it this low. Also, my apologies to all of the fallen soldiers. I was in the military, so I'm not fallen. But to all of those that did, you get one day, where other groups get a whole month. For all of you that fought for freedom, I say thank you. Also, I was just at the beach and they had those things. Those are really cool. It's a tent you put up at the beach. Creates like some huge home. But I just got back from right here. And that's maybe why I got fried. Look at America. That's Texas. Everyone with their flags. I sent it to my buddies and they're like, so that's what you guys do? You put out American flags? I'm like, yep, that's what we do. Not a bad beach, not bad sand for Texas. I'll give you that. Also, thank you for always liking the videos. I really appreciate you. Even though I don't ask, I know I see lots of likes. It's always helping out the algorithm, but you want to know, where's the market going and how can I take advantage of this? Well, let's dive into the NASDAQ. Also, if you are new to trading, I go long above this orange line. I go short below it.
That's what I do. And this is right when I launched my swing trading course. Not bad. And then I launched my bear market course right there. And the NASDAQ went down 37.73, almost 40%. Ooh, that must have been painful. And just in case you wanted to know where you were long, okay, you get above the 200 and I say, get ready. It's going to have a beat down. Oh, it's going to bounce off the 200. Get ready for your swing. Also, for all of the trolls, which no, I know you guys are like, don't let them bother you. Just keep doing you, Bravo. They don't. But they're like, you said the market's going to go down. I said it was going to go down, and then I said it was going to go up. And now I'm going to say it's going to go down again. Then guess what? Then it's going to go up. All right. So now that we got that all corrected, I want to show you guys something. This is actually, it's in my bear market course, and I want to get pretty darn precise on this. This is Fibonacci's. It is not in my swing trading course because you don't need this. This is for later. Other things that are not in it would be like that, right? That's that rising wedge. You don't need that in a swing trade, but in a rising wedge, it does this, and then it breaks to the downside. Huh, why not, right? As the good old saying goes, markets can remain rather irrational a lot longer than you can remain solvent. But what I wanted to draw for you here, this is a 0.618 or 0.618 Fibonacci retracement, which I try not to do too much. It's in my bear market. I have whole courses on this. There is a high probability, and I even have you set up. This is a little golden pocket. I call this the honey zone or the golden pocket, a honey pot, whatever you want to call it. This area right here. I even teach you how to set it up because it won't come with your regular fib. You're just going to go, oh, 618. Okay, your 618, this is, we're hitting right on it. Now, my guess, and I'll put it right here for you, is that it will not get past that. It's going to get rejected. Just like it did in 08, in 2000, the tech, oh my gosh, look at this new puppet. And we have all been there and done that. Well, if you're a trader, you know, you felt it. You're like, how is this happening? How is it these companies with their ridiculous valuations? Until they're not. But you don't understand, Bravo. It is AI and we're all using it every day. You do you. You go long on NVIDIA. It's okay. Even though I can't pronounce it right. It's okay. It just frustrates some people. Also, the rest of the NASDAQ looks like this. Okay? The weighted NASDAQ. All right? Not... can't cherry pick. All I'm saying is just please be careful. And I've helped a lot of people in the Bitcoin, in the gold, in the silver, in the stock market, in the everything. Like, okay, you look at the charts. You understand the charts. Here's the news. Goldman current market is more latte.com bubble than crypto bull market. No, I said latte. It's late. It just feels better. More latte.com. It's, yeah, would you like some? And I would probably say the crypto bull market. I don't know. I mean, we all took advantage of it. I mean, I have a crypto course. Ta-da! Actually, my last trade on Ethereum, I exited my position. Everyone called me an idiot, which I am. I agree. 4,200. I said, I'm out. Prior to that, I was buying in the hundreds, not the thousands. And then just like you and I take that, those digits, and then I go buy things and I go travel and I do what I want to do. So if you're like, oh my gosh, you have so many cool courses. I do have that offer still running, $199. Four payments, you get four courses. Kind of like a four-course meal, you just don't get fat. Well, your digits get fat, hopefully, unless you're an idiot. Then I can't help you. Europe, as the whole world turns, Europe's economic engine is breaking down. Huh, that's weird. Germany is at risk of a long, slow decline with consequences for the whole EU. Germany is in a recession. And America was in a recession with two, count them, two negative prints. But our politicians said, come on, we're going to change it up. Okay, well, you have real GDP, real final sales, and real GDI is telling you you're in a recession. Which if you're wondering, what is GDI? It's actually gross domestic income. That stuff you're hopefully making. See how I turn that word of hopefully you're making to hopefully making. Because I know people around the world are being laid off. Wah, wah, wah. JP Morgan lays off 15% of First Republic employees, or about 1,000 workers. Also, when it comes to those that are employed and not employed, I just want to let you know that within 60 days, that chart goes zoom. So the politicians will be like, well, we're look, full employment. And then 60 days later, they're like, oops. That one, that chart is never a gradual one. Like price declines. Those, okay, all right, takes time. Price declines, the housing market, relationships. Lots more price declines are coming. Okay, real estate, oof. See, commercial real estate, like I can jump up and down about that one. That is a gigantic 21 in the US, $21 trillion dumpster fire, but that takes time. Things that don't take time would be like discount windows when everyone just runs, like the banks. They're like, oh, we're out, right? Or Mickey, we're all gone. Liquidity, asset, see that? See, it's like, it's right here, and then it's way up there. Those are loans, bank, term funding program, and through the roof. 1 minute, it's nothing. Next minute, through roof. Same thing with discount window, right? It's nothing. And then, whoo, wow, that is really something. And also, just to let you know, I believe this one is just the heartbeat. And then it comes down, and then it waits, and then you have another heartbeat. And also, those are not QE. That is not money printing. That is banks with collateral, and they're running to the Fed. Please help us. We're not going to survive, right? And then they like, what do you have? What kind of collateral? Well, you seem to have taken all the collateral out of the market, right? Where's the bonds? Where's the T-bills? They're a-coming, right, Janet? Also, something that is not QE, which people get confused on this one too. This is just you. This is the banks figuring out ways around what the Fed does because they get charged and busted. They're like, oh, I can't have that kind of cash in your balance sheet. You gotta pay the piper. So they're like, everyone move it to money markets. Yes. Look at that. Like pretty high, yeah, from nothing to that's a lot. And by the looks of it, I would say that's not coming down. Which why would you? Because you get zero interest. Why wouldn't you be on a 1 month treasury T-bill? 1 month? What, 5%, 6%? No, it's just sitting in your bank account. Actually, the banks kind of need that right now, so you should probably leave it there. Actually, you can do whatever you want. The end game isn't going to be pretty. No matter a debt deal reached, any of this, the whole system, it's not going to end pretty. I'm sorry. It just won't. And Michael from Wealthion, Michael Pinto, liquidity crunch. This liquid. You guys know what liquidity. Liquidity crunch. To usher in a hard landing. Oh, later this year. So we're okay right now. Well, that is if you like chaos, recessions, depressions, liquidity crisis, banking crisis, and whatever else. But at the end of the day, you can make your digits going higher by going, oh, so markets go up, oh, and then they go down, and then they go up again, and then they go down again, and then they go up, and they go down. Guess what comes after that? So please, Kitty, cue the fire and behind me, yes, and take advantage of the swinging stuff. $199. That doesn't mean you have to be a swinger. You're a swing trader. Also, for those of you that have had family members die protecting our freedoms, yours, my freedoms, I salute you. Thank you guys so much. Also, thank you so much for supporting this channel, all that you guys do. I'm glad I can come here every day and talk a little bit about freedom and where we're going. And I will see you tomorrow.